Cisco SD-WAN Quality of Service tools help us to ensure the quality of applications. One of the most important tools is queuing, which prioritizes delay-sensitive applications and guarantee bandwidth for applications in proportion to their needs, so that junk or bulk traffic does not occupy the entire bandwidth. This is the topology in which we have implemented traffic shaping in the last section. Just to review, four sites, site 1, site 2 to 4, are connected through MPLS as well as internet transport. In both transport, bandwidth is limited to 200 kilobit per second. Therefore, we have shaped our traffic to 200 kilobit per second in WAN edge routers, so that when traffic are sent to ISP, extra traffic are queued in our WAN edge routers instead of being dropped in ISP. Now we can manage queue created by shaping in a way that traffic with different quality of service requirements are inserted in different queues. A queue is treated as a priority queue or a LLQ, low latency queue. All traffic in this queue is forwarded as quickly as possible with the condition that it does not exceed a predefined bandwidth, for example 35% bandwidth. Otherwise, other traffic cannot get bandwidth and they will get hungry. Because of this, extra traffic within priority queue is discarded. Every other queue is guaranteed a percentage of the bandwidth, so we can ensure that every important application gets its own bandwidth it needs. If you remember from previous section, without queuing, our ICMP and SSH traffic were disrupted when we tried to upload a traffic through bulky FTP application. Now, traffic is uploaded through FTP protocol, and this is the quality of our ping without queuing, and this is the quality of SSH. It has a very high delay to be prompted for login and password. As you can see, there is a high delay here in SSH connection. Show policy map interface gigabit Ethernet 1. We have got a rate more than 200 kilobit per second and about 1 kilobit per second drop rate. And you see there are about 400 packets dropped in the queue. Without queuing method, this is just one queue, a class default queue. But in this scenario, we are going to implement queuing so that SSH and ping traffic are not disrupted. With queuing tool, we can prioritize or guarantee a minimum bandwidth to each application so that they are not disrupted when FTP application try to use entire bandwidth. So we will put ICMP traffic inside LLQ or priority queue with a maximum bandwidth of 35%. SSH traffic inside, this is SSH traffic inside Q1 with minimum bandwidth 30% bandwidth, and all other traffic in Q2 with minimum 35% bandwidth. Five steps is required to implement this scenario. In the first step, we create queues with the help of class map to create three queues: Q0 for ICMP traffic, Q1 Q1 for SSH traffic and Q2 for other traffic, including FTP. Q0 is priority queue by default. In step 2, we specify minimum bandwidth of every other queues. Remaining bandwidth is the maximum bandwidth allowed by Q0 or LLQ. QS map must be finally applied to output interface of the router of the edge routers. In the next step, we need to specify which traffic belongs to which queue. This is implemented using accesses in Cisco SD-WAN environment. In the last step, access list must be applied to edge routers outgoing interface so that each traffic is served through its own queue. Now we can start to implement queuing over shaking. In the first step, we create queues with the help of class map. We create three queues, Q0 for ICMP traffic, Q1 for SSH traffic, and Q2 for other traffic, including FTP, through setting, policies, custom option, list, and then class map, ICMP in Q0. SSH in Q1 and bulk in Q2. In the second step, we specify minimum bandwidth of every queues except Q0. Remaining bandwidth is the maximum bandwidth allowed by Q0 or LLQ through the configuration, policies, custom option, and then forwarding class and QS at QS map, QS underline map 1 at Q1, 30% bandwidth and buffer, and the scheduling wait around robin and drop tail drop and save, and at second Q, 35%. And tail drop. The remaining 35% is the maximum bandwidth allowed in low latency queue or Q0 and save policy. The new QS map must first be copied to edge routers before it is applied to the outgoing interface of edge routers. So in the localized policy, in all edge routers, I start with CH1 router, edit, forwarding class, add QS map, import, QS map, import, and we can preview the configuration before it is copied to edge routers. QS map 0 for Q0, the bandwidth percent, scheduling LLQ, Q1 bandwidth percent, Q2 bandwidth percent, and this is our QS map which include 3 QS class, and then save policy change. The configuration must also be copied to other edge routers. Again, policy, localized policy, other edge routers, edit, add QS map, import, QS map 1, import, and then save policy. In SF3, QS map must be applied to internet and MPLS output interface, then through template, feature template. This is internet and MPLS interface. We start with internet, edit. Access list in QS map quality of service underline map one and then update. Let's preview the configuration changes. As you can see, shaping policies already applied to class default in Gigabit Ethernet 1 interface. Now a new service policy is applied to the same class default that manage queues resulting from traffic shaping with the name of QS underline map 1 configure devices. The same configuration must be done for MPLS interface, MPLS, edit, QS map, QS underline map 1, and then update. In the next step, we need to specify which traffic belongs to which queue. This is implemented using access list in Cisco SD-WAN environment, the policy, custom option, and then access list. Add IPv4 access list policy, traffic, underline, to, underline, queue, underline ACL, default action must be permit since we are not going to drop any traffic. Add sequence 1 for ICMP traffic, protocol number is 1, and the action class must be ICMP class. The second rule for protocol TCP and destination port 22, which is SSH, action must be assigned to the class SSH, save. Also protocol TCP and source port 22 is also SSH traffic, which must be assigned to SSH class. And then other traffic, sequence rule, source data prefix, 172.16.11.10.2/32 to 172.16.14.10/32 action class bulk reverse traffic also must be assigned the same class between 172.16.14.10 and 172.16.11.10. STH32 must be assigned to the class bulk. Save and save access control policy. The new accesses must first be copied to edge routers before it is applied to the outgoing interface. So localized policy CH1 first in the access list, add access list, import traffic to queue access list. We can preview the command. This is traffic to queue access list, ICMP traffic to class ICMP, SSH to class SSH, and then the traffic between these two IP addresses assigned to bulk class. And then save. Configuration must also be copied to other edge routers, policies, localized policy, other edge routers, edit, and then access list, import, traffic to queue, access list, and save policy. In the last step, the access list must be applied to edge router's outgoing interface so that each traffic is served through its own queue. It must be done through feature template, both in internet and MPLS interface. Edit. Egress access list, global on, and then the name of access must be copied here. We preview the configuration changes. It shows that the access list will be applied to interface Gigabit Ethernet 1. This the same configuration must be done in MPLS interface, feature, template, MPLS. Edit. Egress access list on and the name of access list and then update. Now we can upload FTP traffic again. It is expected that there is no problem with ICMP and SSH traffic anymore since they have their own bandwidth reserve through queuing mechanism. As you can see, there is no problem anymore with ICMP. Also check the result of our policy with CLI command. Result. As you can see, there is also no problem with SSH. Show policy map interface gigabit Ethernet 1. As you can see, entire interface bandwidth is limited or shaped to 200 kilobit per second, gigabit Ethernet 1. Offer rate is for the last 30 seconds less than 200 kilobit per second. It's going to be increased. And drop rate, we have about 100 kilobit per second drop rate. It's a very high drop rate. Also, it also shows QoS map 1 is applied to the queue resulting from shaping. For each queue, for example, queue 0, offer rate and drop rate is shown. Queue 0 is for our ICMP traffic. This is the only queue that rate of traffic is limited. Since traffic inside this queue is forwarded with high priority, queue 1 is for our SSH traffic. There is no packet match with queue 1, which is actually not as my expectation. And there is no queue 2 at all to match FTP traffic. I'm not sure if there is a mistake in my configuration or it's a bug with Cisco SD-WAN software. I've tried many times the same configuration, but always it shows the same result. As you can see, the Q1, QoS map 1 is correctly assigned. Q1 is related to ICMP traffic. It is 35%. It shows that exactly our configuration is mapped to the shaping, to the result of shaping queue, but I cannot see any matching with Q1, and there is no Q2 at all. And there is no problem with ICMP or SSH traffic.